this real fact, truth. Life is full of challenges, and have right balance of live of will of your life. How do you do that? There are many techniques, there are many ways to do this, but I'll take only 3 points. Organize your thoughts, organize your place, organize your behaviors. These are three key things where you can decide, where you can drive your vehicle to the destination required, you expect. Maybe to a doctor, maybe to an engineer, maybe to any other profession, maybe to get a Nobel Prize. Don't lie. Have that dream from the beginning. If you don't have that dream from the beginning, you cannot achieve it. If you heard about a great philosopher called Michelangelo, not that singer, there was a great philosopher called Michelangelo. He made 2 great statements to this society. The number one is, whether you think you can or you cannot, you are right. Whether you think you can or cannot, you are right. It's you who decide what to do and what's your abilities. The second statement he said was, the biggest disaster is not that you aim high and you lose the aim. The biggest disaster is you aim low and you meet it. That makes your world smaller. That makes your comfort zone smaller. You try to live in a comfort zone. You don't feel challenges. You don't want to take challenges. You want to go with others as they go. Because human beings are unique. Human beings have enormous abilities and potential. And it's unique. One person is totally different from others. You should understand what your abilities are, and you should know where you want to go, not just because your friend is going, not just because your parents want to go. This is not to say that you have to disagree with your parents, but you should know what your challenge is, what your abilities. There's an important say for this. Little push in the right direction can make a big difference. That's the little push I want to give to your life. I'll do a small magic to show this important little push in the right direction to make a big difference. This is a piece of paper. There were magicians like this in the old days when we were schooling, right? I have seen most of those magicians taking a piece of paper and making a crane out of it and saying, I will make this crane fly if you wait till I finish my oil business page. I'm not going to ask you to stay till I finish my oil, but and I'm going to cut this into 2 to start my magic and show important saying, little push in the right direction can make a big difference in your life. Hold it carefully. This scissors is very sharp. If I cut your fingers, I might damage my scissors. Because I have to do this magic every year. Right now I have 2 pieces. Corona, Corona. One child, Hamadharma. I'll paste this. It's a gum. It's a gum tube. I'll paste this and make 1 piece of paper. And I'll cut this in the middle. When I finish cutting, how many rings will I get? How many rings will I get? A little louder, please. How many rings will I get? Dr. Kumari, from next year onwards, you should give some food also in addition to transport. Not to this group. Don't take this group again. Next group. Right. How many rings will I get? Can you show using your fingers? Because I cannot look at your face. If I cut my fingers, I might lose my scissors as well as my fingers now. How many? Can you show using your fingers, please? Separated. How many rings you said? How many rings you said? How many you said? How many is it? Magicians comes with long sleeve shirts, I know that. No, nothing here. Honest. What happened? What happened? This is the little push in the right direction to make your life totally different. You do not need the little push I did. When I pasted it, when I made the ring, I twisted and pasted. How many of you noticed that? That was the little push. It made this different. When you make a ring and you cut in the middle, you normally get two rings. But because of that little twist, it made it one. It's not a magic. So that is the little push I want to give to life. And that's the twist I want to give for your life. The little twist. Through those 3 points. Organize your thoughts. Organize your place. Organize your behaviors. Stop stressing. And life is not to suffer. Life is for enjoyment. You should enjoy every day, every moment. But at the beginning, it may be difficult. It may be bitter. That's the truth. The universal truth is that good things are difficult. Bad things are easy. Good things, good food are not tasty. Healthy foods are not normally tasty. Bad things are easy. Good things are difficult. So to change your life, to follow these 3 steps, it may be difficult at the beginning like medicine. But if you follow it, you will enjoy life. You will reach your destination. If not, you will have a stressful life every day. I'll show you why this man is so stressed. The man is so stressed. So he's trying to release his stress. So others take the person as a job. Now how he releases stress. Have you ever felt doing like that? Have you ever felt releasing your stress like that? The little twist I want to give to life to minimize such stresses. Let us analyze the word time. The first letter, T, stands for things to do list. This is where this little twist begins, to organize your thoughts. Things to do list. Never ever start any activity without writing down what you want to do. Start your day, start your week, start any activity, start the journey, even before going for marketing, with your parents, before going for shopping, before going on a picnic. Whatever the activity you do, please take my word today. Write a things to do list. It's a must. Without that, if you start doing, I will assure and reassure, you will do only 80 to 90% maximum. Sometimes the efficiency will go down to 60% because you try to keep everything in your head. Head has enough things to carry. Never ever depend on your brain for to keep things memory in your brain. Once somebody asked from Einstein, what's your telephone number? Not your telephone number, Einstein telephone number. Einstein took the directory, opened the directory, and Albert Einstein. She gave the number from the telephone directory. And what he said was, why should I keep a space in my brain to remember my telephone? I do not know whether we should go up to that extent, but never try to keep things in your brain, because your brain is much more important to various other activities. I'll tell you what those activities are. If you want to go on a trip, if you want to start your day, write the things to do list. Number one theory. And number two, once you write it, you will start seeing how busy you are going to be and what your activity is going to be, and organizing these activities. I know some people go to town thinking that they may go to bank, they may go to grocery, they may go for shopping, they may pump petrol to vehicle sometimes, and then halfway come back only doing 5 out of 7 things and going back again. And if you have the things to do list, you will know which order you should do. It may be depending on the place, it may be depending on the priority, because you are given 24 hours, 1,440 minutes, and you have to spend some time for sleeping also. You cannot spend the whole 1,440 minutes to work and work. You need some time for rest. So if you have time only, you have to do it. So the second one is identifying priority, the second letter. Once you make the things to do list, you will be able to identify priorities. Whether you should study today or go for a film. Whether you should study today or play a computer game. Whether you should study today or go for Facebook. You will limit your time for going for Facebook. And the third letter, M, stands for make it happen. You may write the things to the list. You may identify the priority. If you don't make it happen, you will not reach the success. And then the last letter, the most important thing, is evaluate deviations. Whenever you do some activity, look at that very closely and ask, is this the best way to do it? If I am given a chance again to do it, is this the way I'm going to repeat the same thing? Don't do the same thing twice in the same way. Try to identify evaluations. Fail to plan means to plan to fail. If you don't plan at the beginning, having a things to do list to organize your thoughts, this is where organize your thoughts comes. When you go for an examination, never ever try to use your first 5 minutes to answer questions. Never ever. Don't touch your pen even within first 5 minutes. Read the question paper very carefully. And try to identify easy questions, that where you can score more than you expected. Read it within 5 minutes before answering. This is one of the biggest mistakes many students do in examinations. Spend first 5 minutes. So, in any activity, you need 3 different times. You need a free time, you need a planning time, and an action time. Before writing your things to do list, you need a free time. Sit and relax for a moment and try to imagine what you're going to do and organize your thoughts before putting it to a piece of paper. Plan in time and then go for action. Make it a habit. You need habits. Make it a habit to write your things to do list before any activity you perform. It can be something like this. Things to do on 14-12-2011. Complete homework, iron shirt for a week, check mobile phone, charge, wireless computer. You write whatever comes to your mind. Try to spend 1 paper per day. Write it down. What great philosopher says is, when you write your things to do list, when you have your things to do list, 70% of your stress, your brain is over. It's converted to a piece of paper and you can see it in front of you, and you will be driven by the objectives, not by circumstances. Because you have an agreement with you after writing.